Welcome to another episode of Tinkerine Experiments. Today, we are going to try and use CLR to smooth out 3D printed PLA models. We use CLR at the warehouse to clean different parts. This household product basically is used for dissolving stains, calcium, lime, and rust. I was wondering, since this product is so powerful, would it actually be of any use to 3D printing, so I thought we should try it out. Here we have a bottle of CLR, but the bottle behind our set is actually a mason jar full of it, which we have used before. So we'll just take it out from that. Please do use your gloves if you're dealing with this chemical. We'll pour it into smaller mason jars and then put our model in. Since our model is floating, we will need to go grab a skewer to prevent it from floating like this. Afterwards, close the lid and we will leave it for a period of time. I've left the model in for actually 4 weeks now. At first, I thought it would dissolve in the time period, but we can still see it. So let's take it out and see whether or not it had any effect on the PLA model. Let's open the lid and remove the print. The print is stuck and I'm actually having problems taking it out. I guess I have no choice but to use my hands. I forgot my gloves, but if you're ever gonna use CLR, please wear gloves. Oops, I just broke the model. The model is actually kind of slimy and smooth. Let's take it to the sink and wash the CLR off and take a closer look at it. Upon a closer inspection, the surface of the PLA is completely the same. I can feel the layers and it is not smooth. Whether or not it is on the base or on the pillar, we can still see the individual lines. I guess the experiment failed and CLR doesn't do anything to PLA. Well, there we have it. We tried using CLR to smooth out 3D printed PLA models, but it doesn't work. At first, I thought the strong chemical would actually eat away or dissolve the surface of the PLA model and it will be very smooth after a period of time, but it didn't come out that way. After 4 weeks, it's still the same, so I'm pretty sure we can safely say it doesn't work and this experiment failed. Before I end this video, I just wanted to remind everyone about Tinkerine U. It's a great platform to explore anything 3D printing. We have a lot of free teaching resources and challenges that you can take advantage of on the platform. So please do check it out. That's the end of our experiment. If you liked our video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you didn't, then a thumbs down below. Remember to subscribe and comment on what experiments you would like to see in the future. Thank you for watching. Tinker out.